Hey Psych2Goers, and welcome back to another video. Your love and support has enabled us to send your way another wealth of everyday psychology, and we're grateful beyond words. Now, let's begin. What is it that makes you say, "I like that person so much"? Is it their compassion towards others, their impeccable character, or their outrageously good-looking smile? It's not always so obvious, but it's the little things that endear others to us. You may have someone you yourself admire, and perhaps you wonder if you too, in turn, are as likable. Well, don't be too hard on yourself, because you may just be more admirable than you presume. Here are 5 signs to key you in if you are as likable as you think. Number 1, you emit positive energy. Did you know how you feel in a setting or situation can impact how others feel around you? So, if you are a little ray of sunshine most of the time, chances are others will feed off that positive energy from you, liking you for making their day as well. A research paper from the University of Hawaii and Ohio State University suggests that many individuals can unconsciously tell what mood you're in just by being around you. Seems fair, right? So if you display positive emotions, others are likely to mimic your happy facial expressions and gestures. Therefore, they're likely to feel positive emotions around you and want to be with you more, meaning they like your company and ultimately you. 2, you listen and let others talk about themselves. Are you a good listener? Do others find it easy to share their thoughts with you? If others look towards you to share what's been on their mind, it's a sign they're comfortable with you, knowing you won't judge or interrupt them. Humans love to talk about themselves, which means if you let them do so, they may just like you a bit more. Harvard researchers discovered that taking the time to talk about yourself triggers reward areas in the brain. And when it's associated with your presence, they ultimately begin to like your company. In another study conducted by Harvard researchers, some subjects even declined money to talk about themselves more. So if you go ahead and let others talk about themselves for a while, they'll enjoy their time around you more and increase dopamine too, as long as you make sure to listen and not doze off. 3, you're human and have imperfections. Do you strive for perfection? Do you wear your mistakes with pride, or do you cover them up to present a perfect facade? Contrary to popular belief, it's one's imperfections that endear you to others and not your perfection. Does the thought of making a mistake terrify you? Well, it shouldn't. Others may be intimidated if you come across as perfect. Mistakes show your human side. When you show you're capable and yet still relatable as a human being who makes mistakes, people tend to like you more. In a study, researcher Elliot Aronson had people rate fake test takers based on their attractiveness. Some test takers would act clumsy and spill coffee at the end of the interview, after their scores were revealed. Poor test takers, mediocre test takers, and even great test takers were still rated lower than the superior test taker who scored great and spilled coffee at the end. Meaning, people want to see you are intelligent and capable, but that you aren't perfect. Number 4, you make great first impressions. Do you believe in that saying that the first impression is the last impression? Are you extra vigilant regarding your attire and behavior during first meetings? If you succeed in making a good first impression on someone, your chances of being liked increases even further. That's because first impressions leave a lasting mark. In a study published in the Journal of Social Psychological and Personality Science, people were to evaluate others based on their photograph and then to meet them. The first impression through the photograph influenced the individual's judgment of the person even after they met formally. So, when you're on time on a first meeting, dress to present yourself accordingly and show your personality through a great first impression. It emits a vibe that others take an instant liking to. Number 5, you have a lot in common. Did you know having something in common with the person you're talking to can also increase the chances they'll like you? In a study by Theodore Newcomb, subjects were made to live together after taking their opinions on certain topics. Those who had more in common and shared beliefs on the topics recorded liked each other better compared to the subjects with opposing beliefs. When there's more to talk about, you find yourself wanting to listen to their thoughts on the subject as well. And you share your opinions in a positive light. Hence, when your like-mindedness surfaces, so does your liking for the other. Everyone likes to have someone who shares their beliefs. And when you find them, well, what's not to like about it? The most important thing is to be true to yourself and show others your real self and personality. Don't try to be someone you're not just to make someone like you. Start your encounters off right by laying the groundwork for a great relationship. Make a great first impression. Share your interests. Listen to the other person's opinion. But hey, if things just aren't working out, whatever you do, maybe don't spill a coffee on yourself. So, do you think these are sufficient to measure someone's likableness? Do you integrate some of these signs or tips into your life? Let us know in the comments below. If you found this video insightful, be sure to hit the like and subscribe button and share it with someone who might benefit from it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.